Unlike some older versions of Windows, such as Windows 7, which came with only the basic applications necessary for normal functioning, Windows 10 and Windows 11 come with a large number of pre-installed applications. Most users do not need these applications, and many are not even aware of their existence on their computers. When it comes to removing these applications, there are several different ways to achieve this. In this video, we will discuss two ways to do it. For the first method, you do not need any additional applications. We will use only PowerShell. All you need to do is run PowerShell as an administrator. You can do this by typing PowerShell in the search bar and then selecting the Run as Administrator option that appears on the right side of the search results. Once the program starts, you can get a list of all applications that come with Windows by entering the following command: get -appx package. This command displays a list of all applications installed for the current user. In other words, for the profile you are currently logged into. If multiple people use the same computer, you can get the list of applications for all users by entering the command get -appx package -all users. As you can see, we will get a very long list of programs along with the certain informations for each of them. You can see the application name, who signed the application, where it is located, and similar details. To remove any of these applications, all you need to do is copy the exact name of the application. If you don't want to go through the entire list and want to remove a specific application, but only know part of its name, for example sound recorder, you can get the details about that application, including the full name needed for its removal, by entering the command get -appx package followed by a space and an asterisk, and then the part of the name you know, asterisk again, and then press enter. As you can see, we will get information about applications where the given word is mentioned. To remove this application now, we will copy the full name of the application and then enter the command get -appx package -name, full name of the application, in our case Microsoft Windows Sound Recorder, vertical line, remove -appx package. When you press enter, the removal of the application will begin. Once the process is successfully completed, we will check if the application still exists on the system. As you can see, we do not get any results, meaning the application has been removed. If you want to remove multiple applications this way, but don't want to remove them one by one, open Notepad or any other text editing program, create a list of all the applications you want to remove by placing the full name of the applications in the quotes and separating them with the commas. After you form the list of applications you want to remove in this way, in the PowerShell, first type add, then open parentheses, copy the names of the applications you selected for removal, close the parentheses, and then type vertical line for each -object, open curly bracket, get -appx package -name, $_, vertical line, remove -appx package, close curly bracket. All these commands will be listed in the video description, so you can copy them and adjust them to your needs. This method of removing applications, while effective, does have its limitations. There are some applications that cannot be removed this way. For example, if we try to remove the Edge web browser, we will receive an error, meaning the removal will not be possible. The second method for removing pre-installed applications in Windows, which we will discuss in this video, is Win11Debloat. It is a free and open source program and it allows you to remove these so-called stubborn applications. The link to the GitHub page where you can download this application and view the source code, since it is an open source project, will be in the video description. This program essentially consists of a set of scripts and you can download it in an application form by clicking on the link in a releases section. When the new page loads, you will find a section at the bottom called Assets. Click on the second link, Source Code Zip, to download the application in a zip format. After downloading the application, right-click on the file and select Extract All. You will be prompted to define the folder where the contents will be saved, choose your desired location and click the Extract button. To run the application, look for an icon, name Run, in the newly created folder and double-click it. A warning will appear stating that the creator of the application is unknown, unknown publisher. If you want to allow the application to run, click the Run button to approve. After that, the program will launch within the PowerShell terminal. In addition to this classic method of downloading and running the application, it is also possible to run the application through a command in PowerShell. On the website from which we downloaded the application, you will find a section titled Quick Method. As you can see in the description, the application can be launched simply by entering the specified command in the PowerShell terminal. Now we will do that. We will copy the command, then run PowerShell terminal as an administrator, enter the command and press enter. Regardless of which of these two methods you choose to run, whether the quick method using the command or downloading the application, the results will be the same. When the application starts, you will be presented with three options. The first option, or option number one, default mode, quickly apply the recommended changes, will remove all applications that are marked as unnecessary. You can find the list of these applications on the application's website by clicking on the file appslist.txt, which contains a list of all applications that the creators of this program have marked as unnecessary. Additionally, if you have downloaded the program, you will also find this file, in other words text document, named appslist.txt in the folder where you save the contents of the zip file. If you want to remove all these applications and apply the recommended Windows adjustments, simply type 1 and press enter. If you want to remove only unnecessary applications, select option number 3. If you want to manually determine which applications will be removed while also making adjustments to Windows, in other words, customizing Windows to your needs, choose option number 2. Custom mode, manually select which changes to make. I will choose this option, option number 2, as it provides the greatest flexibility and guides you through all the possibilities that this program offers. When you enter the number 2 in the terminal and press enter, a new dialog will open where you will have the option to remove all applications listed in appslist.txt, including mail, calendar, developer applications and gaming applications. It is recommended to select the third option in this dialog, manually select which apps to remove, which will allow you to manually choose exactly what you want to remove. When you enter the number 3 and press enter, a new window will open with a list of all applications that come with Windows. All you need to do now is go through the list and check those you want to remove, As you can see, many of these applications are checked by default, but of course, if you want to keep any of these applications, simply uncheck them. Since we are doing this for demonstration purposes, I will check all the applications on the list. After you make your selection, check the applications you want to remove and uncheck those you want to keep, click the Confirm button. If you have selected any applications that cannot be easily reinstalled, such as Microsoft Store, the program will warn you. If you still want to remove the application, click Yes. If you want to keep the application, click No and uncheck that application. Then, you will receive information in PowerShell about how many applications are marked for removal. In my case, as you can see, that is 138 applications. After we have marked the applications we want to remove, you will receive a list of questions related to adjusting Windows. Based on your answers to these questions, the program will, in addition to removing applications, make adjustments to Windows according to your preferences. Enter Y for Yes and N for No. Disable Xbox Game Screen Recording. This also stops gaming overlay pop-ups. Yes. Disable Telemetry, Diagnostic Data, Activity History, App Launch Tracking and Targeted Ads. Yes. Disable Tips, Tricks, Suggestions and Ads in Start, Settings, Notifications, Explorer, Lock Screen and Edge. Yes. Disable and remove Bing Web Search, Bing AI and Cortana from Windows Search. In this segment, since it is related to Microsoft AI options, if you enter Yes, you will receive an additional questions asking you if you want to disable Copilot and recall. Of course, you can choose the option that suits you, but it is recommended to select option number 2, which disable all AI options, as most of these options essentially serve to track user behavior. Disable Windows Spotlight Background, automatic wallpaper changing on desktop. Enable dark mode for system and apps. Disable transparency, animations and visual effects. Again, you can choose the option that suits you, but disabling this option will lead to improved performance of the computer itself. Restore the old Windows 10 style context menu. Turn off Enhanced Pointer Precision, also known as Mouse Acceleration. Disable the Sticky Keys keyboard shortcuts. Disable Fast Startup, this applies to all users. Do you want to disable any context menu options? This is the menu that appears when you right-click. I will disable all options in this segment, but of course you should choose the options that are suitable for you. Next, we have the option to customize the start menu. As you can see, we can remove all pinned applications from the start menu, either for the current user or for all users. I will choose the second option, remove for all users. Disable the recommended section in the start menu. This applies to all users. Disable the phone link, mobile devices integration in the start menu. After that, we have options related to the taskbar. Align taskbar buttons to the left side. Do we want the search segment to be visible, to be an icon, a bar or a box? I will choose the fourth option, box. Hide the task view button from the taskbar. Disable the widget service and hide the icon from the taskbar. If you don't use this service, it is recommended to disable it. Enable the end task option in the taskbar right-click menu. Enable the last activity click behavior in the taskbar app area. Do you want to make any changes to File Explorer? I will say no. After all these adjustments, you will receive a message. Press Enter to confirm your choice and execute the script, or press Ctrl plus C to quit. press Enter to apply changes, wait for the entire process to complete. The duration of the process, of course, depends on the number of applications you have marked for removal. If you have marked the Edge as an application you want to remove from your operating system, since this web browser cannot be removed through regular means, you will be asked if you want to forcibly remove Edge. Click Y, Yes, again and press Enter. It is always important to note that before start any system customization process, including this one, you should definitely make a backup of all important data you have. Ideally, you should create a backup of the entire system so that you can restore everything to its original state if anything goes wrong. You can create a backup of the entire system, hard drive, using Rescuezilla. In one of the previous videos, we discussed how to do this, and if you missed it, you will find the link in the video description. Feel free to leave any suggestions, questions, or ideas for future video content in the comments. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.